Good morning, students. This video is for class 4 science, and today we will discuss the shoot system of plant. The shoot system is that part which grows above the ground, and it consists of the branches, stem, leaves, flower, fruits. So these are all the parts that grow above the ground all makes up the shoot system. The shoot system consists of the stem, leaves, flower and fruits. These parts usually grow above the ground. The first is the stem. Stem is that part of the plant from which branches, leaves, flower and fruits grow. So stem is that part from where each and every other parts grows, like for example branches, leaves, then you have flowers, fruit. It can be either strong or weak, so it depends upon the type of plants. So if a plant is a herbaceous plant, that means the stem will be weak. If a plant is a shrub, then it will be little stronger as compared to the herbaceous plants. But if you talk about a plant tree, that means the stem will be very hard and woody. For example, big trees will have thick and strong stem called trunk, while herbaceous plants like plants, climbers, creepers have weak stem. It can be highly branched in some plants. That means there are some in some plants these stems can be many numbers. Now the function of stem. The function of stem is to provide. The first function is to provide strength to the plant so that the plant can stand straight and upright. Secondly, it carries water and mineral from the roots. It takes water and minerals from the roots and it supplies to each and every part of the plant. Thirdly, it carries food that is prepared in the leaves, and then it takes from the leaves and it supplies to different parts of the plant. And the last one is, the stem can store food in them. They have the ability, the capacity to store food in them. And those stems are eaten by us. For example, potato, ginger, then you have sugarcane. These are eatable stems. The next part is the leaves. Leaves are also called food factories of green plants, as they prepare food for the plants by the process of photosynthesis. So leaf is also known as food factory of the plant, because it prepares food for the plant. That is why they are known as food factory of the plants, and they prepare food by a process called photosynthesis. They differ greatly in size, shape and color. So different plants will have different types of leaves. They will have different shapes of leaves, they will have different sizes of leaf, and even they will have different color of leaves. We all have already read about the structure of leaf in the previous class. Let's review it quickly. You all have studied about the leaf, the structure of leaf in class 3. So this is the structure of leaf. The flat portion, this flat portion is known as leaf blade or lamina. The tip which actually grows, which connects the stem and the leaf, the tip which actually grows, that is known as stalk, or you can call as petioles. The middle portion which divides the leaf into two halves is known as the midrib, or you can call that as main vein. And the network like structure which helps in the transportation of water and minerals to the whole part of the leaf is known as vein. So these are the different parts of a leaf, and you have small holes on the undersurface of the leaf. On the undersurface, those are known as stomata. So this is the structure of leaf. Leaf blade or lamina is the flat and broad part of the leaf, as I have already told you. The part that links the leaf to the stem is called petioles. So this is the part which links the leaf and the branch stem is known as stalk, or you can call that as petiole. The central veins called the main vein that runs along the half of, from the petal to the leaf tip and divides the leaf into two parts. A number of tiny channels called veins. There are many number of tiny channels. They are called veins which runs throughout the leaf. You have it covers the whole leaf. Veins from a network to carry water and minerals to all the parts of the leaf. A number of small openings called stomata present on the undersurface of the leaf helps in the exchange of gases. So these stomata, they help in the exchange of gases. That means they take in carbon dioxide and they release oxygen from those opening known as stomata. Next is the function of leaves. So what are the function of leaves? The main function is to prepare food for the plant. The second is exchange of gases. That means it takes in carbon dioxide and releases releases oxygen. The third is transpiration. That means they give away excess if excess water is present in the plant. Suppose if they have water that is more than what they require, what they need, they will release this, they will throw away this excess water in from this by the help of those pores called stomata. There are some leaves which can store food in them, like for example spinach, then lettuce. So they are eatable. Just because they can store food in them, they are fleshy in eating and it is consumed by human beings as well as animals. So these are the functions of leaves. So I hope all of you have understood this. The functions. The first function is to prepare food by the process of photosynthesis. The second is the exchange of gases through the stomata. The third is the transpiration, that means throwing off excess water, the process known as transpiration with the help of the stomata that is present on the undersurface of the leaves. And they can store food in them so that it is eatable by humans and animals. And one more function is the food prepared by the leaves during the process of photosynthesis is glucose. This food is transported throughout the plant by the stem. So whatever food is prepared by the leaves, those food is transferred to each and every part of the plant with the help of the stem. So I hope you have understood these functions of leaves. So for today we will keep it till here. In the next class we will discuss about the things that we get from plants. So for today up to this much, thank you class.